joining us for a special edition of Scoliosis Dialogues, an SRS podcast. I'm Ashtin Neuschaefer, SRS Executive Director, and today we're going to be joined by the newly elected officers for the Board of Directors to give you a brief introduction to them and their roles and some of the advice that they may have for young members of the society. Today with us, we have David Skaggs, the new SRS Treasurer, Munish Gupta, Education Council Chair-elect, and Marinus de Kleuver, the new SRS Vice President. Thank you so much for joining us.
All right, I'm here with Dr. Munish Gupta, who has been elected to serve as Education Council Chair-elect. He will take over as Education Council Chair at next year's annual meeting. Dr. Gupta, thanks so much for joining us today.
It's my pleasure.
All right, Dr. Gupta, why don't you start off by telling us a little bit about your path in the SRS and how you came to be at this point in your career with SRS?
That would be my pleasure. I think I should start with how I finished my training in 1992. And my first SRS presentation and my first meeting was in 1993 in Dublin, Ireland. And it was a truly memorable event. And I don't think I've missed an SRS since. So I've been part of the SRS. I think the only time I missed it was the 9/11 in Cleveland. That was the only time I missed that. But the rest of the SRS meetings I've attended because I'm very passionate about spinal deformity and its treatment, and I've basically focused my entire career on it.
Great. Tell me a little bit about the service that you've done for the society. I know you've served on a lot of committees, chaired a lot of meetings and courses for us, been really involved leading up to this point.
Sure. I was involved in SRS from the beginning, and I've chaired some committees and I've participated in committees. I think the most memorable ones have been the translation committee, which didn't exist when I took over, making a very big thing where we translated all the educational materials as well as all the website materials in 12 different languages, if I remember correctly. That was a big undertaking, but the members that I recruited and they were part of this committee were fabulous. They did an amazing job getting it done. And then some of the other ones that were memorable were the global outreach, which has been my passion throughout my life, and also the membership committee, which is truly the committee that makes sure that our membership is of the highest quality and does what they're supposed to do, as well as other committees, but I can't name them all to get there.
Absolutely. We know that you have quite the resume with SRS. Tell me a little bit about why you wanted to serve on the SRS Board of Directors at this time.
Well, you know, education is my passion. As you know, I've been, I think, teaching for the SRS in every part of this world, from Indonesia to Siberia and everything in between. Actually chaired quite a few courses. And I think the most memorable course was my 2008 course in India. It was a freestanding SRS scoliosis meeting, and we had people from all the Asian countries, the European and North American participants, which was one of the most memorable meeting I've ever organized. So I really think the education is one of the pillars of SRS because we're basically exchanging knowledge from all the different parts of the world. We have 64 countries represented. It's a truly international organization. So it's fun to go to the meeting, exchange ideas, and learn from all the spine surgeons from all around the world.
That's wonderful. And what are you looking forward to most in serving on this role?
Well, I think I want to carry the flag farther for the SRS. There's some exciting new inventions that are coming, this blended learning opportunity we have where people can take their time to learn on their own pace using the online platform, which is quite valuable. Also, the global education is quite important to the SRS and important to me. I think that's one of the ways we're going to take the education far into different parts of the world where, you know, they may not have that opportunity. So we can help so many more patients in that respect.
Great. Well, thank you so much for spending a little bit of your day with us. We're really looking forward to having you serve in this role and seeing where you take education and SRS in the future.
Thank you. My pleasure.
Next up, I'm joined by Dr. Skaggs, who is now serving as our treasurer on the board of directors for the next few years. Dr. Skaggs, thanks so much for joining the SRS podcast.
Hello, Ashtin. How are you today?
I'm doing great. We're so happy to have you here. Why don't you start off by telling me a little bit about your path in SRS that led you to serving at this level in the board of directors?
So I've been going to the SRS annual meeting for the last 25 years. And of all the meetings I go to, it's the one meeting that, you know, most clearly speaks to me. It talks about what I do on a daily basis. And when I was asked to be on the board of directors at first many years ago, I was kind of thrilled to even be in the same, you know, room with the people whose textbooks I read and whose papers I read, and then did one more stint on the board. And now that all of my kids have left home, I have more time to contribute. I'm hoping to see what I can do to make the SRS a little bit better and hopefully have the same effect on other surgeons as the SRS had on me.
And what are you most looking forward to during this time on the board?
Well, being on the board allows, one, the possibility to really serve. And, you know, at this point in life, what makes people happy isn't getting more for yourself, but serving others. It allows us as a group to really teach the world how to treat kids and adults with spinal deformity. So it's a little bit of giving yourself to something bigger than yourself. You know, we know from all the studies that if people just pursue their own little world of wealth or whatever it is, you're really not that happy. It's only when people start to pursue, you know, bigger picture of thinking of others, you become happier. And I think being on the board of the SRS really just allows you to contribute to something bigger than yourself. Now, the other great thing about being on the board of the SRS is working with great people. I have no doubt that I will learn, you know, leadership from other people, that I'll learn how to do better spine surgery, how to better care for patients, and how to be a good human being. Just spending time with people at that level is invigorating and makes you a better person.
What is one piece of advice that you would give to a young SRS member or future SRS member if they really wanted to be involved in SRS and eventually ascend into board service?
So to young SRS members, my honest advice is family first. And I think that you never want to do so many things that your family's in the background because you'll live to regret that. You know, I've never once regretted putting my family first, and I don't know anyone else who has either. Now, that said, if you're in a position where you can do something for the SRS, you can run a meeting, you can contribute, do it well. So only take on things that you know you can do well. And if you're not sure you have time for something, be honest and don't take it on. You never want people to say, they didn't do such a good job at this, because you won't get asked back. Only take on things that people are going to say, wow, they knocked it out of the park. Let's see what they do with the next responsibility.
Great. Well, thank you so much for your time today. We are so looking forward to having you on the board of directors and to seeing where you go in the future with SRS.
Well, thank you so much, Ashtin. Great to talk to you.
Closing out the episode today, we have Marinus de Kleuver from the Netherlands. Professor de Kleuver, thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you, Ashtin. It's a pleasure to be here.
To start us off, why don't you tell us a little bit about your background, especially your early years in SRS?
So the SRS has always been special to me because my mentor used to go to the annual meetings all the time. And for me, it had some kind of magic ring to it. And my first SRS meeting was in Cairns in Australia. And what drew me there, what appealed to me there, is that it wasn't such a commercial show as most other spine meetings are. And there was a very collegial atmosphere there. People were welcoming. I was a young surgeon and I felt very welcome there. And that line has been consistent throughout my SRS meetings. I remember cycling with Jim Ogilvie, past president of the society in Edinburgh. Larry Lenke, another past president, invited me to San Diego for a globalization committee meeting. And Kamal Ibrahim, another president, invited me to worldwide courses. So without actively searching and trying to get in, I was actually being pulled in by all these really influential people. And I thought this way the society worked and the way we as a society, try and make people enthusiastic for our work and to the benefit of our patients. That's something very, very special about the SRS, the dedication of the members and the welcoming atmosphere. So I starting a long time ago, every time it was a step forward, and it's always been a great pleasure and working for the society, meeting people across the whole world.
That's wonderful. Tell me a little bit about some of the roles that you've had in SRS and how they brought you to become vice president of the society.
Thank you. Yes, well, of course, everybody who wants to become a member as a candidate has different candidate roles in different committees. But my first big committee role was in the worldwide courses. The worldwide courses were being run by Ahmed Alanai, and I was a committee member. And then I took over from him as committee chair, and I helped organize 4 or 5 worldwide courses across the world. And in that way, I got to learn and got to know so many people all across the world. And that was a major step. After the worldwide course committee chair, which is a 3-year role at the time, I was elected to the board as a director at large. And after a 2-year period as director at large, I was nominated to become research council chair. That was the role I fulfilled the last 3 years. In that period, we revamped the research, but the whole strategic overview was performed of our society. And the Research Council work was what I enjoyed very much. And then, of course, after the Research Council chair, I was nominated to the presidential line just only a few weeks ago. And so since a few weeks, I am now on the presidential line to ultimately become president of this society in 2 years' time.
What are you looking forward to during your time on the presidential line?
I'm very much looking forward to actually, you could always say, harvesting all the things and investments that we've performed as a group over the last couple of years. We've reinvented our education. We now have lots of online offerings. We've got early onset scoliosis modules. There's a spondylolisthesis educational module coming on for blended learning. So our education offering has become very much more aligned with current educational standards across the world. We've taken an in-depth look at our research, which means that we now have new research categories. And just this month, we've started a call for a directed research proposal looking at long-term outcomes of idiopathic scoliosis, which is almost a $500,000 grant that we're trying to fulfill the coming 3 years. We've had a research agenda. And so both our education offerings and our research offerings have been looked at in depth over the past 2-3 years. And I think that we're very much positioned now to really enjoy the benefits of all those reorganizations that we performed. And of course, following on from that, or at the same time, we had the COVID challenge the last 2 years, which may still continue to challenge us the coming years. We had to adapt our physical meetings and our annual meeting and our IMAS meetings. So whilst reinventing research, optimizing our education, we've also reinvented our annual meeting in IMAS. And all those things are going to come together the coming years and are going to be really exciting. I think it's really important for us to make sure that we keep the culture of our society alive. And for that, the face-to-face meetings are truly important. I've always enjoyed the annual meetings at IMS. I mentioned that earlier just now. And we have seen online meetings, of course. We had to perform online IMS. We had a hybrid meeting just now in St. Louis, where, for example, I couldn't come because of travel restrictions. So we realized that online offerings for our annual meetings are valuable. They've helped us come through this COVID period so far. But the true positive vibe of a physical meeting, the culture of our society where we include people, we try to be inclusive, the meeting where we can meet each other, have informal chats over a cup of coffee, a cup of tea, or a beer. So I think the future will continue to have physical meetings. There will, of course, be an online offering for our physical meetings. But I think that the annual meeting and IMS, getting them back on the road again, predominantly physical face-to-face meetings, is one of the things I'm looking forward to very much.
Wonderful. And any parting words or pieces of advice for our young members?
Yes, of course. I think first of all, referring back to my earlier comment, I was almost pulled into the society by senior members who were always welcoming. And I was daunted by big names and, you know, people I only knew from literature and from papers and presentations. And suddenly they were talking to me, drinking a cup of coffee with me. And I think despite the fact that it may seem daunting to be at a society meeting like ours, please make sure you step up to people, talk to people, enjoy the collegiality. It's a really enthusiastic bunch of people. We really have a clear mission. Our mission and our purpose is to foster the care of patients with spinal deformity. Everybody is focused on that. And because we have this focus and we're a niche, it really is a group of people who you will enjoy working together with. So don't be afraid to approach people. Come to meetings. Feel free to talk to people. Join committees. And you'll have a great time with the society.
Great. Thank you so much for joining us today.
Thank you, Ashtin. It's a pleasure.
DePuy Spine, being a proud Double Diamond sponsor of the Scoliosis Research Society, would like to invite you to visit our professional education website at www.jnjinstitute.com and view the comprehensive surgical videos related to cervical and thoracolumbar deformity. For additional information, please contact your local sales representative.
Thank you so much for joining us.
The Scoliosis Research Society is a nonprofit professional organization made up of physicians and allied health personnel. Their primary focus is on providing continuing medical education for healthcare professionals and on funding and supporting research in spinal deformities. Please visit srs.org for further information.